Last week, we showed you a very exciting new sport from America called skateboarding. Well, we've got another American sport. This time, it's just a little bit faster.
She's real fine, my 409. She's real fine, my 409, my 409. Well, I saved my pennies and I saved my dimes. Giddy up, 409. Before I knew there would be a time. Giddy up, 409. When I would buy a brand new 409. 409. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, 409.
Giddy up, giddy up,
giddy up, 409.
Giddy up, 409.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up.
The number one class in drag racing is called Top Fuel Racers.
That's it.
And this is the fastest Top Fuel racer in Europe. She's recently broken 6 seconds, 5.93 to be exact, from a standing start over a quarter of a mile. And Peter Crane was sitting in the car at that particular time. He's her driver. Peter, hello. To explain Top Fuel racing for a start, what does that mean?
Well, this particular class of car, which is run on nitromethanol, because it's run on fuel rather than petrol.
Nitromethanol is a pretty expensive fuel to run on, isn't it?
Yeah, it's about 7 or 8 pounds a gallon now.
And how many gallons do you get through to do a quarter mile?
About 6 or 7.
It's an awful lot of money. You, I'm told, do from 0 to 100 in under a second.
That's right, yeah, 0.9 to be exact.
I think everyone at home ought to think about that for a minute. 0 to 100 in 0.9 of a second. It's unbelievable. Does it frighten you?
No, if it did, I wouldn't do it.
When did you do your fast run, 5.93?
Easter, it was.
And that was against the top American driver?
Yeah, Don Garlitz, their world champion.
The pressure is on indeed. The quickest qualifier, Peter Crane, against Big Daddy. The first European to actually race the king. The atmosphere is electric. Garlitz in the right-hand lane and Crane near to us. But the design of Garlitz's car causes the foul light to come on and Crane wins a great race and it looks like a good time.
As we've already said earlier on, the sport started in the States, and now you've been invited to go and race there, which is quite an honour, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it's the first time anybody outside of America has ever competed. And it'd be the first time that their sort of world championship is a real world championship.
And that's what you're going for, their world championships?
Yeah.
When are you going?
It'd be about the second to last week in August.
So we'll obviously have to follow your progress. Let's have a look at the car. First of all, we should have said that she's called Stormbringer. Everyone has a name for their vehicle, don't they?
That's right.
And you haven't got much room here, have you?
Well, it's just basic. Yeah, we've got the steering wheel. That's the gear lever. It's got a two-speed transmission. That's the fuel shut-off.
Yeah.
The magneto kill switch, and that's the handbrake, the parachute.
Go
well, you have disc brakes on the rear, but that's not enough to stop you from over 200 miles an hour.
What does it feel like?
It's very exhilarating.
Well, behind, we've got some very large tyres back here, haven't we?
Yeah, these are 17 inches wide. Oh. Under acceleration, the centrifugal force causes the tyre to grow, and it just comes in. It grows about 4 inches in height. With a centrifugal force.
It's unbelievable, isn't it? I said 5.93. That was actually upgrading you slightly, wasn't it?
Yeah,
it was 5.97.
That's correct, yeah.
Can you bring it down to 5.93 or below?
I hope so, yeah. I hope so.
With your trusty team of mechanics
yeah.
around you?
Well, we try to improve each time out. That's the name of the game.
Drag racing doesn't just involve top fuel cars and street cars. There's another broad section with lots of different classes in it, and that's competition altered. And that means cars with a chassis that's recognisable from a car of the present or the past, but a very different and much more powerful engine underneath. So we're going to be watching in a few seconds Tony Merry in a 53 Ford Popular with a Chrysler engine, and a lady driver, Sue Coles, in a Model T Ford chassis with a Chevy engine. Here's another fun car. This is a junior dragster, a converted go-kart, and it can certainly give the Ford Pop a run for its money. Motorbikes have their classes in drag racing too. But whatever the class, you certainly wouldn't see these sort of starts on the ordinary roads. Whoops, there goes a back axle. Before racing, all drag racers do what's called a burnout at the starting line, spinning their wheels on the tarmac to burn a layer of rubber onto the track and leave the tyres hot and more able to grip the surface at the all-important start. The cars are then immediately reversed or pushed back to the starting line. And the race is on. Having seen that lot, I've got to have a go myself, haven't I? So Tony Vanderput very kindly and very bravely, I think, has lent me Warrior, his big Chevrolet. It's a street legal car, that means it's legal to drive on the roads. And I'm looking forward to having a go.